Hello everybody and welcome to episode 200.
Episode 200.
Episode 200. All right. Get back to the rant now. Fuck. Episode 200. Of Mad as a Goat, and today I want to talk about many things because it's episode 200. Is he gonna talk about 200 topics in one rant? Impossible. It would go for days. You wouldn't be able to sit through it. Your mouth would get dry. You'd be like, I need something to drink. Should I hit pause? But what if my internet connection goes down? First world problems. Today I want to talk about first world problems. This idea came to me through the visionary of my genius friend, his brother. He's a subsidiary of the genius, but not a genius. I don't know how it works. I'm not a fucking DNA expert. Moving on from that. Anyway, he talks about things like being in the middle of a video game and the motherfucker crashes, or there's a glitch, or something goes wrong of any sort of, you know, kind of way of nature. I don't know how these things work. I don't sit inside all day. Just any day off, I just sit inside all day. When I go to work, that's basically when I go out. I'm a nerd, shut up. Anyway, yeah, so he enlightened me about these first world problems. Many of us have first world problems. And isn't it kind of hilarious how, like, we get worked up about stupid shit? We really do. I get worked up about some of the dumbest crap. And these rants are documented proof of first world problems in most cases. When you really think about it, most of the things that I rant about, a person in the third world country is going to be like, yeah, well, road rage, I'm fucking dying, you know? It's kind of like a bit more serious from their perspective, yeah. So I was thinking about this. We do have a lot of first world problems in our days. You know, a lot of things go wrong. Like, for instance, you wake up in the morning and your internet's down. Oh man, I can't update my Facebook and all that. You get worked up and pissed off and go to work in a grumpy mood because that's the start of your day. But really, that's a first world problem. Like, really, should we be upset about it? Oh, Nicki Minaj and Drake and all that made shitloads of cash making moronic music that people decided to buy. It's so annoying. Why don't I get any recognition? First world problem. You know, it's a very good term. If you don't take it too serious, you know, first world problem, it's like, well, I'm in the first world, so my problems matter, fuck everyone else. But it's a good way of putting things in perspective. Started as a joke, but I'm kind of getting enlightened from it. Many of the things that annoy us in our day-to-day life really don't matter. I've done rants about the penis size thing, you know, the thing that men worry about a lot, their penis size. There's people in the world who are just worrying about not being blown up today, you know? When you put it in perspective, does it really matter? And then it doesn't. You just go, well, I'm doing pretty fucking sweet. And it really gives you a good perspective. And that's the thing that our generation, as far as the mainstream is concerned, or the way the media is portraying our generation, it would seem that we don't have that perspective whatsoever. People crying and whinging because they can't go to the prom. Back in the day, you just went, oh, and went to your room and jumped out the window and did it anyway. You just kind of dealt with shit because it's a first world problem. I'm not going to go on my Facebook and make a whole status about it. We do whinge. We do whinge in the West because we got it so good. When you don't have it so good, you're not so inclined to whinge. You know what I mean? Like, even, you know, places that are under a dictatorship, like I think China is, if I'm not mistaken, my geography is fucking shithouse. I don't know where America or, you know, somewhere like Germany is in relation to where I am. Over there would be my best guess. I'm never going to be able to fly a plane. Anyway, but think about dictatorships. Now, those people have it pretty bad living under the dictatorship and under a kind of ironclad rule, I'd say kind of a Nazi sort of style thing, you know, a lot of propaganda and whatnot, under a dictatorship. Even if the dictatorship is removed, they're probably still less likely to whinge about it, as much as if a tourist from like Australia went over there, like, fucking hell, mate, he's just a fucking cunt. He doesn't let you do shit, mate. I was just like cracking open a VB, right, and trying to look under this girl's burqa. And he's like getting soldiers and shit. You know, you'd have a lot of whinging going on. But because those people live with less means than us lucky people, then they're less inclined to whinge, they're more inclined to protest and do shit about it. You look at them and say, oh my god, that whole country went to war. That's an easy way of looking at it when you're coming from the West. For a war to break out in Western culture in the more developed countries would be ludicrous, because we have so many rights and things that we can do. There's really nothing really at this point to revolt against with violence. But if you're living under a dictatorship, I mean, they're fucking with you at any means, just at everything. Just getting a loaf of bread, just surviving is a pain in the ass when you're in a dictatorship, you know? Like, things can fuck up all the time because the dictatorship said so. One slip of the tongue and boom, you're in prison, you know? And it, yeah, so it's easy for us to go, oh man, they, you know, they're crazy motherfuckers. But if you look at it from where they're coming from, look at somewhere like Iraq, why they have so much violence going on there. Well, look at where they came from. That doesn't excuse the behavior. Yes, they were doomed to die. They're a result of their upbringing, they were doomed to die just because of that. Unfortunate, yes, but it's really the only humane way to look at it. If you look at it any sort of thing like, well, they wanted to kill millions and billions of people, but they died. You know, it's a very complex issue. And really, at the end of the day, I do rant, I do whinge. I'm just talking about things you should pay attention to, because we have all these freedoms, so we have the freedom to make it even better. So it's not negative. It's basically talking about freedoms. Freedoms of speech, freedoms of action within reason, people. No more violence and crap like that. Action within reason. And reason is the best thing, the best freedom that we've been given. Reason. To use our logic. Take advantage of using your logic, people. Use your logic every day. There's people in dictatorships, there's people in war-torn countries who don't get to use logic because of lack of food and nutrition. And people take it for granted. That's when I get a little bit annoyed, where it's like we have all this freedom and some people choose not to fucking use it. Use your reason, look through the bullshit, look for what is really there, you know what I mean? Anyway, that's a little bit philosophical, trying to look at all things, first world problems. Matters of Goat episode 200. Thank you to everyone who's been watching and all my subscribers.